Hello dear student, I am expecting that the work given to you in the previous video is clear to you all. In the previous video, what things we have studied? How to read the time, how to write the time, how to use AM and PM, where to use AM and PM and the 24 hour clock time. Today we are going to start the conversion of time from the higher unit to lower unit and from lower unit to higher unit. Vice versa. Okay. So what if you remember, I told that whenever it is 12, if it is in noon hour, we will write it down here noon. Or whenever it is midnight, we will write down here 12 midnight. Okay. We will never ever write 12 a.m. or 12 p.m. Why? A.m. means anti-meridian, before noon. Okay, means before 12 o'clock. PM means post meridian, after 12 o'clock. So at 12 it is neither AM nor PM. Clear? This thing I told you. The second thing I told, when we are converting into the 24 hour timing, if it is written there 12:05 PM, I told if it is PM, you have to add 12. But whenever it is 12:01 to 12:59, we will not add 12. Why? Because if you see the clock, this is 12 and after 12, this is 1. Okay? So from 12 to 1, when the hour hand will reach from 12 to 1, it will cover total 59 degrees and then it reaches to 60. Okay, so when it will reach to 60, it will go to 30, that is 1 p.m. So before 1 p.m., whatever timing is there, that will be remain same, 12:01, 12:02, 12:59, 12:45, whatever timing is there, it will remain same. Only what we will do, we will remove the p.m. and we will write down there 12:05 hours. Similarly, whenever it is 0:05 AM, okay, in that case, what I said, if it is AM, it will remain same only. But if it is 12 hour timing, we will 00 will turn to 12:05 AM. Okay, we will not write it, leave it like that to 0:00. No. Because at 00, when it is coming? When it is 24 hour and the new day is going to begin. So when you are writing it in AM and, sorry, it is R, I'm sorry. This is R. So 12:00 to 5 hours is equal to 12:25 AM. Means at the midnight. Hope this is clear. So now shall we begin with the conversion of the time? So we are going to begin with the conversion of time. First of all, we will begin with the minute and second. And before I will start this conversion, I just wanted to tell you about the table of time. What is that? 1 year is equal to 12 months. Okay. Then 1 month is equal to 30 or 31 days or 29 days we are doing. But whenever we are going to use the conversion table, we will neither use 29, 28, 31, 30. No. Only we will use the one time. 1 month is equal to 30 days. Okay. I will explain you why it is. That also I will explain. So 1 month is equal to 30 days. 1 month is equal to 4 weeks also. Okay, then 1 week is equal to 7 days, 1 day is equal to 24 hours, 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes, 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. This is about your syllabus. Okay, many more are there, but that is not in your syllabus. So, why it is 30 days, that you should know. We are taking an average, okay, conversion whenever we are doing. So we know that how many days are there in a year. This is 365 days, okay. And when we will divide 365 days by 12, it is 12, 3 jar 36, 0. This 5 will come down. 12 zeros are 0, and this is 5. So 30 days 5 means we are getting it 30 days here, and this 5 is extra. It is also a day only, but it is not coming in the quotient field. And whatever the quotient is coming, we will consider that as an average number. So we can write that 1 month is equal to 30 days. So now we are proceeding to the conversion. It is written that 10 minutes is equal to how many seconds? First of all, we have to write, as I explained in the measurement lesson, the first point is we have to write the unit, and that is 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. 1 marks. Okay? The second step is, this implies 10 minutes is equal to 10 multiplied by 60 seconds, and it is equal to 10 6 zeros are 0 and 10 6 are 60. So it is 60 seconds. There are some children, those who are not comfortable to multiply it horizontally, so they can multiply it vertically and multiply. But if you remember multiplication by 10, 100 and 1000, I taught you, whenever we are multiplying any number by 10, 100 and 1000, first we multiply by the number 10, 6 jar 60, and after that we will increase 1 0. So directly also we can do it. If this question is coming in 1 marks, like choose the correct answer or fill in the blanks, you can write direct answer like this. But if it is coming in the 2 as directed, that convert the following, we have to show each step. 1 marks, 1 marks, 1 marks, total 3 marks. So please don't forget to do it. This is very important. If you are not writing, you will lose 1 marks for that. And if you are written here 600 and not written second, you will lose 0.5 marks for the unit. So these two are very important things in the conversion. Okay. Now we are proceeding to the second one. 10 and half minute. We can write it 10 minute plus half minute. Okay. Half minute means 1 minute is equal to 60. So half minute is equal to 1 by 2 of 60. So we will write down here 10 minute. First we have to write 1 minute is equal to 60 second. This is the important point. So 10 minute plus 1 by 2 of 60. So this is 10 multiplied by 60 second plus 60 divided by 2 second. Fraction lesson I already taught you, so I don't have to explain again. 600 plus 30 second. This is 630 second, and this is the answer. Here. Now this third question, from the lower unit to the higher unit. In first one, what we did? Higher to lower, means minute to second. Now we are proceeding to second to minute. Okay. So first thing, we will write the table. What is the table? 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. So this implies 1 second is equal to 1 minute divided by 60. Okay. This is minute. Same, what we did in measurement lesson, the same thing. Higher to lower, multiply, lower to higher, divide. Okay. Then we are proceeding here, 480 second is equal to 480 divided by 60 is equal to, we will make a rough column here and divide 480 by 60. 48, so 60, 10 is there, so 68 jar 480. If you remember while teaching the multiplication and division by 10, 100, 1000, what I told, if we are dividing by 10, the 0 will be multiply in 10, okay? 10, 20, 30, 40, 20, 40, 60, 80. If it is 3, read the table of 3, 3, 2 is 6, 3, 3 is 9. So similarly, 30, 2 is 60, 30, 3 is 90. This one I explained in the class, so I don't have to recapitulate again. I'm just telling you. So 6, 8 is 48, so 68 is 480. So it is 0, it will be 8 minutes. Whatever is quotient, that is the higher unit, and whatever is remainder, that is the lower unit. This you have to keep in mind. So how many seconds are left? 0 second means the complete number, that is the 8 minute. The second one we can see, 870 second is equal to dash minutes and dash second. First part, write the unit. 1 second is equal to 1 divided by 60 minutes. This you don't have to write because first question I explained you from where you got this one. That's why I wrote this. But now you will directly write 1 second is equal to 1 divided by 60 minutes. Okay? So this implies 870 second is equal to 870 divided by 60 minutes. Now same process, we will divide it. So make a rough column here. All the operation is a measurement portion. Now we will do it. If you are not able to write horizontally, add horizontally, or not able to multiply horizontally, you have to do it vertically. Make a rough column on the side of the question only. Clear? So 870 divided by 60, 61 is 60, 7 minus 0 is 7, 8 minus 6 is 2. This 0 will come down, 6 4s are 24. After the number, so it is 0 minus 0 is 0, 7 minus 4 is 3. So what is this? Higher unit, quotient is always higher unit, so this is minute, and whatever is remainder, that is a second. So we will write down from here, the answer is 40 minute 30 second. This is clear to you? The next conversion is from hour to minute, and we are going to start first. The unit is 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. Okay? First part is, this is compulsory to write. Then this implies 9 hour is equal to 9 multiplied by 60 minutes. And this is equal to 9, 6, 54, and after that we will increase 1, 0, 5, 40 minutes. Some of you are not able to do it horizontally, so what you will do, you will make a rough column, multiply 60 by 9, 9 zeros are zeros, 9, 6, 54. So, you don't have to indicate how I will multiply 9 into 60 horizontally. You have the option. I am always telling you, whenever you are not confident, make a rough column and you should check the process. Okay? Now the same process you will repeat in the second one. Here hours and minute both are there. So we have to convert into the minute. Minute is already there, so that part we don't have to convert. So what we will do? Just write down first 1 hour is equal to 60 minute. So this implies 10 hours, 10 minutes is equal to 10 hours plus 10 minutes. This is the first part. Okay? Then convert this hours into minute. 10 multiplied by 60 plus 10 minute. This equal to 10, 6 to 16, and 1 0 is already there, so plus 10 minute, and this is equal to 610 minute. This is what I told you directly, but in case if you are not confident what to do, 60 multiplied by 10, 0, 0, and then 1 6 to 60. Okay, and then add this 10 here, 0, 1, 6, and this is the answer. Okay, so it is not, I never told that do it like this only. No, you can make a rough column and show the process if you are not confident. But I am expecting that till now you have done all the operations, addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. So I am expecting that you are very much competent enough to do the work mentally. Okay, so learn the table, practice more so that you can do all this work mentally. You don't have to show the rough work and all. So next is from minutes to hour, lower unit to higher unit, we have to divide. So unit is 1 minute is equal to 1 divided by 60 hour. Okay, so 1200 minutes is equal to 1200 divided by 60. Now, if you are not confident enough to do it directly, what you will do? 1200 divided by 60. 12, 6, 2 are 12. So 62 are 120 minus this is 0. This 0 will come down. 60 zeros are 0. So it is. So answer is 20. Okay? So it is 20 R. Next, 1350 minutes, the first step is 1 minute is equal to 1 divided by 60 hour. So this implies 1350 minute is equal to 1350 divided by 60 hour. Okay? Same process, make a rough column, divide it 1350 divided by 60. First we divide by 6, 6 2's are 12, so 60 2's are 120. 5, 3 minus 2 is 1, this 0 will come down. Again 60 2's are 120 minus this is 30. So whatever is quotient, that is the higher unit, so it is R, and whatever is remainder, that is the smaller unit, that is minute. So we will write down from here directly 22 hours and 30 minutes. So the next topic is 10 days into hours. So conversion of days into hour. And unit is 1 day is equal to 24 hours. Again and again I am repeating beta. If you will not write this unit, you will lose 1 mark in the conversion. If it is filling the blanks or choose the correct answer, no issue. You can write direct answer. You can solve with the mind or you can solve with the rough column. You can write direct answer. Steps are not required there. But if it is dual directed and of 3 marks question, it is compulsory to show each and every step. You are going to get marks for every step. So if a single step will miss, you will lose the marks. Okay? So first step, 1 day is equal to 24 hours. So this implies 10 days is equal to 10 multiplied by 24 hours. Okay? Multiply it, 24 multiplied by 10, 10 4s are 40, 0, 10 4s are 40, 10 2s are 20 and 4, 24. So it is 200 240 hours. Now next is 7 days 10 hours, same process. First we write down 1 day is equal to 24 hours. So this implies we will separate days and hours because already 10 hours is there, so we are not going to convert hours into hours again, that is the difference only. So we will separate 7 days plus 10 hours. Okay, now we have to convert only days and then we add the hours in that. So 7 multiplied by 24 plus 10 hours. This is multiply this. 24 is 168 plus 10 hours. And this is 178 hours. Okay? If you are not able to multiply directly, what you will do? 24 multiplied by 7. 7 4 is 28, carry 2. 7 2 is 14 and 2, 16. 168, and then we add 10 in that, it is 178. Clear? So both the way I explain you, conversion of the higher into lower and lower to higher. The last topic is left from the hours to days. So that we are going to start. So this is from hours to day hour. First we will write down 1 hour is equal to 1 divided by 24 days. Okay, so this implies 340 hours is equal to 340 divided by 24. Day. Make a rough color. You can do directly also, but in case you are not knowing how to do, so I am going to teach you. 340 divided by 24. 34 is greater than 24, two digit division. 24 1 24 minus 4 minus 4 is 0, 3 minus 2 is 1. Then bring this 0 down, this is 100. Now we will read the table of 24, till the time we will get the number here, means less than this 100. So, some of you are knowing the table how to do and some of you are not knowing. So, how we will know divide by 2 digit? We will take the 10th place and read the table of 10th place. 2, 4, 8 and 2, 5 are 10. Now, here is also 10, so we will just make a rough column and 24 will be multiplied by 5. It is coming 120. Okay, which is more than 100, so we will not, we are not able to go 24 5 sir. So what we will do, we will go for 24 4 jar. This is called try and hit method. If you are not knowing the table of 2 digit number, in that case, what we are doing, we are taking the 10th place, reading the table of 10th place till the time we get the number equal to or less than this one. Okay, always we prefer to take the less only. So, 4 times we will go, 4, 4 are 16 and 4, 2 are 8 and 9. This is 96. So, we will go, 96 is smaller than 100, so we will go for 4 times, it is 96. So, 100 minus 96, it is 4. So, what is the quotient? That is the higher unit, it is the day. And whatever is remainder, it is the lower unit, it is hours. So, the answer is, directly from there, we will write down 14 days and 4 hours. Okay? This is about the all the conversion from the first one, minute to second, second to minute, hour to minute, minute to hour, then days to hour and hour to days. This is there in your syllabus. Along with this video, there is a PDF also attached there. Go through with the PDF, see the video properly, understand the topic and solve it. Okay? And I will suggest you please utilize each and every second of this holiday for the practice. Maths need more practice beta. It's not compulsory, only 4 questions are given in the PDF, so you will do only 4. Solve each and every questions of the exercise so that you will be competent enough. Okay? Please, all the best. God bless you all.